Hello and welcome to Abhi channel. Today I'll be reviewing the book written by Sheldon Katz called Enumerative Geometry and String Theory. So I stumbled upon this book a few days back and I immediately issued it from my institute. So enumerative geometry is something quite a niche thing because everyone knows differential geometry, everyone knows fractal geometry, everyone knows Euclidean, non-Euclidean, and all kinds of geometries exist in physics and in basic mathematics itself. So there is algebraic geometry also, which is very philosophical kind of thing. But enumerative geometry is something that it's always the backstage kind of thing in the mathematics research. So enumerative geometry is a very old thing. Means people noticed and tried to study it way back. So it's about solving the problem of intersections. It's not like parallel skew lines in 3-4 dimensions intersecting or not intersecting. It's more involved than that. It has some various assumptions. I won't get into the details, but enumerative geometry is mainly dealing with intersections of lines. And now what I thought first of all is this might resemble a knot theory. So knot theory is another kind of very unique kind of mathematics that people develop coming from the knots, and I have felt it this thing might be a point set topology or something like that, but it's a field of its own and it has a different mathematics. So right now this thing is quite a placid, and the only thing that's driving ideas in enumerative geometry is string theory. So, at the back of the book, we have what are the essentials in order to understand. So, you should know basic geometry and basic concepts of topology, cohomology, and we have to understand some kind of physics that goes in string theory. So, the action principles in string theory and what are the major things and formalisms in string theory. So let's get into the book first. Let me go through the index. So there is, as you can see, this book is not popular science book like Brief History of Time by Stephen Hawking. It is going to have a lot of mathematics in it. First of all, it's warming up to enumerative geometry. This chapter will be telling about his history a bit and then what it exactly is. Then it will directly dive into test situations enumerative geometry is being applied, like projective plane. So then there is a concept of stable map. Then there is topology and manifold, which is quite essential to understand string theory. Then there is complex infinite dimensional manifold and cohomology. Again, that's very essential. And then at the last, we have enumerative geometry of lines. So let me just go through the introduction. Okay, there's also some more chapters about mechanics, supersymmetry, string theory, topological, quantum field theory, quantum cohomology, enumerative geometry, and so on and so forth. So yeah, there is quite a lot of things in this book. I think so. It's better if you just skim through this book if you are new to physics and new to string theory and new to algebraic geometry and topology, field theories. If all these things are sounding new to you, it's better if you just watch this video and skim through this book. So I'll be just skimming through it right now and just tell about what I feel. So as you know, I do not have any formal physics degrees or mathematics degrees. I'm completely self-taught, but that's not anything big because nowadays we are in the internet age. Okay, so there is basically the history of enumerative geometry, when it started, in the 20th century, and Hilbert stated his 15th problem, which has fundamentals of enumerative geometry and some kind of proof. So the problem was, how many geometric structures of a given type satisfy a collection of geometric conditions? So yeah, that's the thing. So basic enumerative geometry kind of tells that in how many ways can four lines intersect, and there is only one answer or something like that, given some test conditions and like that. So yeah, okay, let me just skip all this thing, but there are quite a lot of definitions to give the flavor, and there is also exercises at the back of this book. This book is quite thin, but still it is covering all the things around topology and string theory and this niche field called enumerative geometry. So yeah, so this test case in projective plane. So yeah, we are kind of there's like some definitions about some sets and some subspaces, and how we can apply this kind of geometry to get some results, or maybe to try and get some representation results. It's like both are quite the only products that we get in mathematics. There's not like we in applied mathematics we get everything. In numerical simulations we do get, but in theoretical mathematics it's only about representation and some key results that really count, that you can really call as math. Okay, stable maps and enumerative geometry, I won't go into it, but I'll just link this book in the description. I do not think the ebook is available. If it is, I'll link that too. So yeah, as you know, string compactification is one of the major things, and here in the last chapter there was a problem of compactifying the space of smooth plane conics. So yeah, so compactifying is one kind of another thing that you really need to know topology inside out, and string compactification has been a very trendy topic for last 40 or 30 years. So that's the thing. So let me just skim through this book, let me just go to what is exactly string theory and how this book builds itself to string theory. So yeah, as I've read it through literature survey, there were first five different theories of string, some including different groups, there were type 1, type 2, and then NR something, string theory, and some string field theory. So there are many formalisms, and they all got integrated by heavy mathematical connection theorems kind of things, and they all are now kind of unified. So yeah, let's just see how they introduce. So they just take away they just start away with bosonic strings in Euclidean space Rn. So they just define this field of the bosonic string, and then they tell the compact surface which is having a C infinite manifold structure. So the surface is assumed to be orientable. So yeah, that's another property that you have to explore when you are studying compactification and various string theories, definitions. So yeah, the reason they are just telling about some why geometrically we call string theory something like that. Yeah, and then there is a definition of the Riemannian metric, which is always used in such theories a lot, and there is also a lot of things which I really can't explain right now because they are really tough to explain. Things which are tough to explain, there are either two things: it's really tough, or the person who is explaining hasn't completely understood it. So I think it's both of that thing. So yeah, BRST cohomology being explored. So yeah, that's also a thing. So yeah, let me just see about enumerative geometry that is covered. The last part, I think so. Quantum cohomology, enumerative geometry. I think so. I'm missing out this section that I want. Okay. What do I want? Yeah, this thing. Enumerative geometry of lines. Let me go to that. Okay. So yeah, there is matrix representation. Yeah, there is like various spaces called P3. There is the Grassmannian, which is another like. It's a very important tool that people do while studying and solving some key issues in string theory. So you have to take the Grassmannian. I really can't explain it in a short, so I won't tell. So yeah, so it is just taking one test case and telling how you can analyze this space and how you can study lines or using this enumerative geometry. Okay. So yeah, there is some theorems, some proofs. It's not really going into the rigor of string theory. And enumerative geometry itself has not been developed fully or connected with all sides of topology. So there's still a lot of work yet to be done in it. I really don't follow research of algebraic geometry and all that, but I really sometimes encounter these formalisms and definitions, and I just try and see if it's related to somewhat what I want to study. So like about string theory. So yeah, this is as you know, enumerative theory is about intersection theory. So this is about excess intersection. So the title is quite provocative, but yeah, in the math book, this thing like only this title, which is like still technical, it looks like something different. Yeah, so your tangent bundles and vector bundles, that also a thing which really need are really used in string theory, and there is various math that fit all that things, all that concepts. So yeah, in and all, this book is really useful if you want to get a side angle on string theory. AMS publication has made this book. So I am definitely going to give it a read. If you have any doubts and want any further explanation on any stuff, please link it in the comments. Please say it in the comments so that I can address it. And if you think you kind of want to correct me somewhere, please do, because I am a learner and my learning rate is quite low. So it would be helpful if there's some external help. Thank you for watching.